free. I am living for eternity. Free now, forever. You pick me up and turn me around. You set my feet on the solid ground. Yours now, forever. I am chosen, I am free. I am living for eternity. Free now, forever. You pick me up and turn me around. You set my feet on the solid ground. Yours now, forever. And nothing's gonna hold me back. Nothing's gonna hold me back.
ask you to play that one more time, but I want to say something. I'm going to do a lot of paraphrasing here and a lot of twisting, a little bit of twisting around of Scripture. Elijah and Elisha were buddies. And how many of you remember before Elijah was taken away what Elisha asked him? What did he want? He wanted a double portion. And what did Elijah say to him? You're asking a hard thing. You're asking a hard thing. But if you see it, it's yours. If you don't see it, what do you get? Nothing. What are we singing here? About how much we believe. But the first part, he can do anything. He can do, and if he can do anything, guess what we can do? We can do anything because he's inside of us. All you got to do, you have to connect with what he believes. If you don't connect with what he believes, he's there, well, you're not getting anything. You don't believe it. You know, you don't believe. I don't know how many of you are in a position right now where you're going through something that you just can't see it. You can't see it happening on the other side. But this tells you, believe. What did Jesus say? If you only believe. That's all. Only. You know, and if you look up that word only, it probably means only, like it's the word like way down here someplace. Only believe. That's all you got to do is only believe that God's thoughts towards you are what? They're good thoughts. God doesn't, you know what? God doesn't, I don't think there's a day where God gets up and he says, I don't know how I'm going to do this. I got to tell them they're losing their job next week. That's not a good thought. All right? God's thought, matter of fact, what does God say in that scripture? Prosperity. The word prosperity is mentioned. God wants you to prosper. Not only your spirit, but your soul. The whole man has to prosper. You can't just prosper in one area. Man, I go to church, I have a great time. As soon as I go out the door, oh, I'm so hungry all the time. I never have any food. No, that's not God. You got to believe God wants to supply all your needs. All your needs. So be encouraged.
I'm not gonna live by
break our walls down. Spirit, break out.
Talking to somebody, and it was this crane, and the thing was miles high, and the person said, "What? Look what happens when this church, when this crane lifts this church up." And all of a sudden, there's this building, an old, it looked like an old, almost like an old congregational church, the old with the steeple on top. It was a yellow church, and this crane started lifting this church up, and it went up, and this thing went way up. And at this point, I was looking at a bird's, it was like a bird's eye view that I saw was going on, and there was other people with me, because I remember conversing with people. And this crane started lifting up this church up, and it went high, and it went beyond the clouds. It was up, way up high. And all of a sudden, this crane let this church go. After a moment, after going up way beyond clouds, this crane let this church go, and it felt like forever. This church building was just falling down. It was coming down back to earth. And all of a sudden, it hit the earth. And there was you see this huge cloud of smoke just erupt, and all of a sudden I look and there's a highway, and these cars were moving on the highway, like from the explosion, the cars are like going all over the place on the highway, kind of like just skidding all out of control. And then I kept on looking, and I don't know how it had to be far away, because I says, wow, look at that. And it was so far, I don't know how far it was, but you could see that the water was rippling. And so far away. And I remember Nate was there, because I told Nate, I said, look at Nate, look how far this is reaching. It's way beyond. And even though it's so far away, you can still feel the effects of that happening. And then I woke up, this is about 5 a.m. I woke up, and all of a sudden I got Jacob's Ladder came into my mind. And I had to go up and look it up. And it says Jacob had this dream, and they were ascending and descending. And then I remember Brother Johnson talking about it. It starts at the bottom, and you ascend first, and then descend. Then he started singing his song, "Spirit Break Out, Heaven on Earth." And our prayer is that heaven, what on earth as it is in heaven. Well, the way it's going to happen is when we ascend and into the heavenlies and pull down onto earth and bring it down to earth. And I just had to say that, and I knew I had to say it today, and I was like, I'm not saying nothing, I can't. And then it's funny because I told the girls today, I says, if you feel an unction to get out and dance, I says, get out and dance. Not thinking I had to get out and say something. So.
Overflow. Kingdom come, your
Father, we need you today. More than our minds can comprehend. Father, we declare that it's all about you. It's about your transformation in our lives. There are some things, Lord, in this natural life we just can't change. But Father, you can change it in us. So Father, we submit to you today. We surrender, God. We surrender absolutely everything to you. Until you speak, you begin to declare into our lives, God, transformation that changes us from where we're at to where you're taking us, God. We are submitted, God, unto your divine plan and purpose. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, God. Thank you, God, we submit. We surrender, Jesus. Take us, God, into that high and holy place. Into that dimension that's beyond human understanding, God. Even as Paul declared, God, he once knew a man who was caught up. Take us, Lord, into that caught up place. Into the third dimension, God. Beyond the natural realm, the natural mind, the natural understanding. And Father, we might live in that realm and bring that realm to earth because you've equipped us, Lord, to care about your kingdom, your purpose, your will. The mighty name of Jesus. The mighty name of Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, God. Thank you, Lord.
Of God, fall fresh on.
Sandra, I don't know what this means to you or whatever, but I heard the Lord say, whatever it is you've cried for years, now is the season for it to come to pass. Whatever that means, I have no clue what that means, but it looks to me like something you've cried for years and years. It goes way back. And all I heard the Lord say is, this is the season for its fulfillment. Okay? Nate, I heard the Lord say to you that it's going to cause you to become a torch. Even as the Gideon went and set the tails of the foxes on fire in the realm of that mixture and all of that with the Philistines, he's going to make you a torch. And you're going to run as the torch of the Lord. I saw it like, you know, when they announced the Olympics, the guy with the torch and they run with it. That's what I saw. That's what I saw you. Like one with the torch is going to come to announce a new dimension in your generation. I think it's in your generation. That doesn't mean it won't affect other people in other generations. But I heard the Lord say it, or it seemed to me like the Lord was saying it was in your generation. You'll be a torch carrier. That's a torch of the Lord. Amen. The Spirit of the Lord. Praise God. Thank you. Thank you, worship team. I just want to, some of our folks got to leave. They got to go to a wake, and they got to travel up into Vermont. So everybody that's got to